Member for Denredah.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I rise on behalf of the people of Denry North to support the motion that is before us and to affirm the commitment of the parliamentary opposition to the motion as presented by the Prime Minister. Mr. Speaker, ours is a position that has been eloquently espoused by the Leader of the Opposition at least three times prior to today in the last week. And if you want to factor his presentation, which was concluded mere seconds ago, I think this is the fourth time I'm hearing the Leader of the Opposition pledging support and pledging to work collaboratively with the government on a matter or situation that confronts our country. Mr. Speaker, as it relates to COVID-19, our country is at the crossroads. And the coronavirus-induced crisis, if not handled properly, as we've seen in other parts of the world, we will be faced with a situation where disaster and calamity will consume hundreds of St. Lucians, if not all of us. Mr. Speaker, we can quickly become overwhelmed by the situation. And although there has already been a reliance on our brothers and sisters from Cuba and elsewhere to help with the situation, I believe there are a number of things we can do for ourselves to help contain the spread of the coronavirus. Little things, Mr. Speaker, things that we've been spoken to about by the Bureau of Health Education: wash our hands, practice social distancing, refrain from spreading information that is not reliable. Very, very simple things. And I think the Leader of the Opposition was on point when he said, Mr. Speaker, and also the Prime Minister, that COVID-19 or the coronavirus does not select or choose classes or categories of people to infect. It is not concerned about gender. It is not concerned about age. It does not care about your political affiliation. And so, Mr. Speaker, the only way we can objectively combat this phenomenon is for all national patriotic hands to be on deck. This is not a time to play politics. This is not a time for us to posture and to flex the muscles of power that we have. Mr. Speaker, the responsibility belongs to all of us. And as one of the highest decision-making forums in this country, the eyes of the national community are fixed on the parliament. And I don't think or believe that there's ever been a time in the history of this parliament where our maturity will be placed under greater scrutiny. And it is for this reason, Mr. Speaker, whereas the political leader of the St. Lucia Labour Party, member for Castries East and leader of the opposition, has pledged our full support, now is the time for us to embrace each other's contribution and the positions that we assume on this national crisis. When we on this side postulate or prescribe certain approaches, Mr. Speaker, let the debate be one where we are only discussing contending ideas. Let this be a contest of ideas. Let it not descend into a personality thing. Because I'm sure all of us in here have constituents who are very apprehensive about the situation that is before us. Mr. Speaker, moi voulais pour l'occasion, même qu'on leader opposition, pour dire que nous avons supporté des marches gouvernement à point pour essayer de contrôler ça nous a créé le coronavirus. Et leader opposition, même qu'on premier ministre a dit, cette maladie, ce n'est pas Yon qui a choisi qui qualité de monde qui a attaqué. Il a attaqué grand monde, jeune monde, femme, homme. Il va mêler qui on est là, qui 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 est là, Et que nous avons un pays dans cette liste. Manière, maladie, ça a affecté gros pays. Pays qui n'a pas bon système de santé. Juste vous, Mr. Speaker, quand vous avez des difficultés, côté vous passez à contrôle, maladie, ça et puis vous avez acheté assistance pour vous joindre. Là, il parle plus bonheur, le Premier ministre l'a dit, que nous avons une assistance hors place contre Cuba pour aider nous à abattre la situation. Ça se bat et nous, en les façades, ça, bienvenue. Ça se bat et nous avons encouragé. Et nous avons aussi dit, Monsieur le Speaker, que l'année en pile, nous venons au Parlement et nous parlons, l'année qui est mettée, et que c'est le monde qui a crié mon nom, et que le monde qui a essayé de faire. Mais depuis COVID-19 et le coronavirus, ça c'est un bon exemple, ça c'est un bon lait pour nous moucher peuple cette liste, pour nous travailler ensemble pour bénéficier toutes les gens cette liste. Parce que nous tous qui ici, nous avons une constituency, nous, Mr. Speaker, qui n'y perdent pas, nous avons qui passe à une manière pour aller à bord de pour quitter les corps et puis les familles. Mr. Speaker, this is not a matter for the Prime Minister and his cabinet only. The opposition must be allowed a place at the negotiating table. And not for decorative purposes to say at the end of the day that it was bipartisan and we had representatives of civil society organizations. But Mr. Speaker, most importantly, when the opposition is invited to the table, our contending points of views must be valued and respected for what they are. And I can tell you with all the sincerity that I can muster that we have never in the last 2 to 3 weeks embraced or adopted a posture where we are about scoring political points. This is not a time for the politics, as I said, because there is a crisis on our doorstep. This is not a time for anybody to cry wolf. This is not a time to try and elicit sympathy for the things we probably would have done wrong in times gone. But instead, Mr. Speaker, we must all put our shoulders to the wheel and we have to do whatever is necessary for the betterment and benefit of the people of St. Lucia. But COVID-19 also provides us with an opportunity to engage in a bit of introspection. Yes, we have to be preoccupied with fighting the disease night and day. But, Mr. Speaker, we must always find a little moment to reflect and tell ourselves that perhaps some of the things we would have done in the recent past, upon reflection, probably could have been done differently. But that is for another debate. Mr. Speaker, you will permit me, of course, to highlight the impact that this particular phenomenon is having on communities. For instance, in my own community and constituency, Denry North. The people of Olio, Despin, Gadet, Larissus, La Pelle, Denny Rivière, like their counterparts in all other parts of St. Lucia, Mr. Speaker, are extremely concerned about a full-scale outbreak of the coronavirus. In recent days, I have seen the apprehension and fear in the eyes of my constituents. I've heard the concerns in their voices. I've read the hundreds of text messages, and people are apprehensive. Lania Perez. C'est pas pour dire ça c'est un bail qui a fait en 1960s qu'on a espéré un monde qui s'est fait. It is right there on the television screen, Mr. Speaker. They are seeing the scores of coffins being moved in military vehicles in Italy so that those bodies can be cremated as a means of minimizing the spread of the disease. And the Prime Minister made the point when he was on his feet. Just imagine, Mr. Speaker, your parents have been in isolation and quarantine. You're not allowed to visit. And the last thing you would have heard of your parents is that they have passed and you're not even allowed a funeral service or a proper burial. And as he quite rightly said, in our culture, just imagine people having to live with that particular reality. Just imagine, Mr. Speaker, that see mama or papa ni COVID-19 or coronavirus. Et que vous passez à venir ouais, vous passez même aller à l'hôpital pour ouais. Et que l'autre pour entendre votre maman ouais, papa ouais, ben issue ouais, c'est un monde qui a crié au bout de lui, il a mort. Mais pour empêcher disease la spread ou si mais ou pas ça même ni en l'étèrement côté ou ça tiré maman ou et bien papa ou. Yo kay pren koy apre a mort et puis yo kay mené aller en machine ami et qui va aller avec brûler body a avec la seule manière yo ka contrôler manière this is like I see. Finally, Mr. Speaker, there's been a very unfortunate situation that has developed right adjacent to my constituency. And we are learning that people from Martinique, which is a country that is infected with the coronavirus, are infiltrating the country through the back door. And that the Louvet Beach, which is not too far away from Olio in my constituency, is one of the entry points for those persons in Martinique. Ever since the demise of our banana industry, a lot of people from my constituency have resorted to a life in Martinique where they work very odd jobs, Mr. Speaker, to earn a living for themselves. And with all the panic that has been triggered by COVID-19 coronavirus, some of them are fleeing from Martinique and they are finding very creative means to enter. Mr. Speaker, I want to take the opportunity in this honorable house today to appeal to all my constituents and St. Lucians who have relatives in Martinique, who know that they are planning to enter the country through the back door, to let them know that they need to desist from doing that. Je voudrais prendre l'occasion pour dire toutes les gens constituents, et puis cette liste entièrement, qui connaissent les gens, les gens et les familles qui Martinique, qui veulent vivre cette liste, pour dire, juste prendre un petit patience toujours, et puis rester coyé. Pas entre les pays through backdoor, through Louvet, through Fondor Beach, et bien pièce l'autre beach en pays. Là, vous faites ça, Mr. Speaker, vous mettez plus de monde en danger. Là, vous quittez maintenant que vous venez, que vous allez à la caille, vous mettez Ishio en danger. Vous mettez Maman en danger. Vous mettez un rôle en community en danger. Je vais prendre l'occasion pour dire que c'est les gens qui sont Martinique, aussi qu'on sacre cette liste, qui connaît les gens qui sont Martinique, pour dire restez là, espérez bien ça. Gouvernement a une manière pour contrôler la maladie avant de savoir entrer en pays. Mr. Speaker, I do not condone my constituents or any other St. Lucians entering through the back door and placing additional strain on a health system which is already overwhelmed. Mr. Speaker, but we must understand that in this time of crisis, people have a tendency to panic. And so, we as the leaders, not only must we put the structures in place, but we must always show a bit of empathy and concern for the individuals who would have been displaced or the individuals who are exhibiting signs of anxiety. It is necessary to quarantine them, Mr. Speaker. This is new territory for a lot of them. And people act sometimes, not because they are malicious or they are not law-abiding, but you must understand that there is a level of anxiety and panic that this COVID-19 coronavirus has triggered. And so I want to appeal to the authorities that whereas the quarantine is necessary, let us ensure that the people as much as possible are living in humane conditions and that their rights are not trampled upon. Mr. Speaker, there are a number of elderly people in my constituency and in St. Lucia generally, and in all of the opposition constituencies, as well as the constituencies that are led by members on the other side. We know how susceptible this can be for the elderly in our midst. And so, Mr. Speaker, very, very quickly, I want to appeal to family members, those who work at the call centers, those who travel the public buses, those who are still being defiant to the guidelines that are being preached by the Bureau of Health Education, Mr. Speaker, to ask them to conduct themselves in a way that they will not be putting their families at risk. And very, very lastly, Mr. Speaker, I saw something that happened in my own constituency where the parish priest, Father Raj, conducted a funeral which ordinarily would have had scores or hundreds of mourners, but the people were able to cooperate and we had just a score inside the church. And I suspect this is how it will be for the coming days. So, Mr. Speaker, once again, I want to, as I said, reaffirm the commitment of the opposition to whatever guidelines, whatever posture that the government is going to assume. We have concerns, but today we will not play the role of obstructionists, and we really wish that all St. Lucians will cooperate with the authorities to ensure that we get some measure of control on the COVID-19 coronavirus situation. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.